a young man that's in a little bit of trouble, Michael.
Oh, Y2J keeps putting his foot in his mouth, and he really did it tonight. He asked Torrey and Stephanie McMahon Helmsley where the Godfather was. Basically, he mistook him for Godfather's lady. So Stephanie, open mouth, insert foot. Chris Jericho's good at that. So it's supposed to be Chris Jericho versus X-Pac, but Stephanie's made it Chris Jericho versus DX, Road Dogg, and X-Pac.
You don't cross the boss or his daughter.
Welcome to Tampa is Jericho! And it seems that I highly insulted Stephanie McMahon Helmsley when I mistook her for one of the Godfather's ladies. And I was gonna come out here and apologize, but since I'm getting screwed in this handicap match anyways, I might as well get my money's worth.
What?
So it seems, Stephanie, that The Rock and all of these Jericho-holics were correct in calling you a bargain basement.
No! He can't say that!
He just did.
He's digging himself
deeper.
But
on top of that, I think you're the filthiest, dirtiest, most disgusting, skankiest, brutal, bottom-feeding, trash bag hoe that I have ever seen in my life.
Who's that?
Damn,
blonde?
I feel better now.
Who's the blonde with Stephanie?
I don't know, but Stephanie can't be liking what she's hearing out of a Y2J who is in deep here tonight on SmackDown.
Just shut up, Michael. I want to hear a little bit of Run DMC right here.
King, it's off the Aggression album.
I know that. Will you shut up?
Run DMC, the Kings.
I listen to him in the Kingmobile all the time.
Kingmobile. You got a CD player in that thing?
I'll let you ride in it sometime. Look at that Aggression CD right there.
X-Pac and a Road Dogg in a handicap matchup against Y2J Chris Jericho. Match set up by Stephanie McMahon Helmsley. Hey, King, I'll tell you what. Mr. McMahon is not here tonight, but Triple H, Shane, and Stephanie have had no problems at all setting up some matches. They've been very vindictive here tonight on SmackDown.
Look at Tori, boy, is she looking hot tonight. She got a stake in this, too. She was highly insulted. How could somebody mistake her for a common everyday streetwalker?
Let me see. And next Pac and Road Dogg is set to take on Y2J handicap action. Still to come tonight in another matchup set up by the McMahon-Helmsley faction. The Rock teams with the Acolytes against Triple H, Big Boss Man, and Bull Buchanan. And I'll tell you, King, I still can't.
Look
at this now. This is a handicap matchup, not a two-on-one at the same time.
Same thing. What the heck?
Jericho whipped off the ropes and knocks down the Road Dogg. Oh, and what a heel kick to the face by X-Pac.
You gotta be ready, Jericho. You're ready to run your mouth. You better be ready to back it up.
Well, he stepped in it deep here tonight on SmackDown.
Shut up!
And it's the capacity crowd in Tampa really getting on DX. King, to get back to the Rock story for just a moment, I can't get over the fact that the Acolytes and the Rock are going to team up. I mean, can the Rock actually trust Farooq and Bradshaw?
Well, he better be able to trust him. Like I said, he can kiss his career goodbye right here tonight.
Yeah, it could be a 5-on-1, and it's a 2-on-1 right here. X-Pac and Road Dogg double team. Look at this. Jericho in trouble.
Oh, no!
Nobody hold.
X-Pac in trouble.
But Road Dogg picks up the pieces. Jericho, baseball slide between the legs. And here's Road Dogg with those left hands. The jab to the face of Jericho.
This is what's bad about a handicap match.
Uh-oh, misses with the right hand. And Jericho counters. X-Pac, look out. Going for the walls of Jericho. The walls of Jericho. Then he couldn't get it locked in. And X-Pac with a kick to the midsection.
Hard to get anything locked in when it's 2-1.
X-Pac went for the X-Factor. Jericho countered. Jericho, look out. Oh, what agility. And King, can you imagine what it would be like if Jericho pulls off the
ring? Tori's in the ring. She's going to take matters into her own hands.
Well, Tori's upset with Jericho.
Uh-oh.
Y2J, look out. Look out.
She's not one of the Godfather's ladies. You can't do that.
Jericho and Tori. Walls of Jericho and Tori.
What's he doing?
And Road Dogg from behind. Hey. X-Factor.
What are you doing?
X-Factor by X-Pac.
Hey, count. Recovered
by Road Dogg. It's over. DX steals one after a valiant effort. And Stephanie McMahon Helmsley loves it. And the punishment has been delivered.
You all right, Tori? You okay?
A great effort by Chris Jericho. But DX picks up the win as Stephanie McMahon Helmsley celebrates.
What's up with your actions of late? You are a terrible official. How dare you? How can you even involve your nose in my business? Don't cut me off. You understand me? You just sit there and think, matter of fact, I should fire you on the spot. I should fire you right now. Matter of fact, you are. What?
Hold on. Don't go that far. I'll tell you what. Maybe we should just put you on probation. Maybe that's the key.
We should fire him right now.
You know what? Maybe he can make this up to us. We'll just put you on probation. I'll tell you what, though. Earl, this is your last chance. You screw up one bad call, one more screw up, and you are fired. You understand me? Fired.
Fired! You got that? Now get out of here! Out! Now! Now!
He better make this up to us. See what he did last when he shoved me?
What'd he do? I think we're gonna bring him over here and see him up. Ooh, hey.
Okay, what is this all about? As Stephanie McMahon Helmsley's making her way to the ring with someone. Yes, that blonde was with her. You know, King, I don't agree. We just saw Shane and Triple H put senior official Earl Hebner on probation. I don't agree with that at all. But
wait. You don't agree with that.
They didn't put him in
the ring.
They put him in his place.
Wrestling Federation Women's Champion, Stephanie McMahon Helmsley.
Fire him. Earl Hebner was just doing his job, King.
He shoved Shane. He shoved the WWF Champion.
Well, what I'm curious about is what did Triple H mean that Earl Hebner could make it up to himself?
I'm curious about who did this.
We saw her sitting with Stephanie McMahon Helmsley earlier on this evening.
You know, pink's one of my favorite colors.
I'm sure. Stephanie, the WWF Women's Champion. Her, Shane, and Triple H have been making matches all night long here on SmackDown.
I don't blame her. She's a very beautiful woman, not to ever be mistaken for one of the Godfather's ladies. And now I think we're going to be honored to hear from her.
Now I understand how hard it is for all of you to look at us WWF superstars and our svelte bodies.
Yeah.
Our hard bodies.
Uh-huh.
Woo. But I want you to know it's a lot tougher for all of us to look out at all of you.
I've been saying that for years. Oh my God.
You're nothing but fat, lazy, cellulite-ridden people.
Yeah.
And quite frankly, you make us sick.
Look at that guy.
They're really going to be jealous. They're very jealous.
So now, as the WWF Women's Champion, I not only represent all of the women out there, but I represent all of the men.
That's right.
And your fat kids, too.
Ah. Yeah!
What?
Come on!
Look at that blubber butt!
You guys know it!
So, going to do a public service.
Public service.
I would like to introduce to you my personal trainer.
Yeah.
And now yours.
All right.
Muffy.
Muffy.
Come on, let's go. Come on, everybody, stand up.
Look at that.
Wait a minute, King. It's The Rock. The Rock set the team with the Acolytes.
Tell The Rock, are you man enough to tell The Rock whether or not you got bought off by Triple H and the McMahons or not?
Yeah, we're mad enough not to tell you a damn thing.
You're just gonna have to trust us.
Can The Rock trust the Acolytes? We'll find out! Rock teams of the Acolytes, next!